Hey everybody, I have a really cute book today. I think you animal lovers will really, really like it. This book is Fantastic Flora and Fauna Cuddly Cats and Kittens. Very, very cute. This is by Dawn D. Boyer, PhD. I hope I said that right, Dawn. This is such an adorable book. This is the back cover where she explains a little bit about herself. I love the coloring, really pretty, and then a picture of her tells a little bit about her. There are 25 plus pictures in here. They are single-sided, well, technically single-sided, and I'll tell you why in a minute. She was kind enough to sign it for me, thank you. At the beginning is really interesting because she gives a really nice introduction to herself and tells a lot about, you know, how she got to be where she is now, with the coloring and everything. She gives some sample pages here. Very cute. I like that. Right here you have some different ways that you can use the illustrations in this book. Very, very, very helpful. And then she has some lessons that she learned along the way to help you. So let's get started. I said that they were technically single-sided because on the pages before or behind, however you want to say it, she gives a little description of the page, the next page. She describes it or talks about, you know, her thinking while she was drawing it, etc. But let's just flip through. Very, very cute pictures. This monkey is so adorable. The paper is quite thin. Yeah, it's like copy paper. But, I mean, it's single-sided, so you can, any media on here will work fine. Look at the little kitten hiding right there. That's the first time I noticed him. Her illustrations are very detailed, really, really pretty. This fence with the roses, gorgeous. Let me see if I can click in a little bit. I love the little sleepy kitty. I have two cats, so yeah, this book was really, really cute. Right up my alley. This page is really, really sweet. She dedicated it to her mother and her little kitties. Really nice story here. And her little kitty, really pretty one right here, out the window. I love the hummingbirds. We call these 4 o'clocks here. I don't know what y'all call them. The staircase. Look at all the details that she puts in her pages. Isn't this nice? I love the kitties right there. These look like Siamese cats. There's a kitty right here. I mean, it's just full. Full of detail, but not overwhelming where you can't do this, you know, in a night or two. This is one of my favorites. I really like all the flowers and the cactus and the details. The little fat cat. So pretty. Oh, that's a little skunk. Looks like another skunk. There's the cat up in the tree where it should be, if there's a skunk down there. I just love all her buildings and designs, and the flowers are just perfect. That looks like the little cherry blossoms to me. Cats love to sit in windows. I know mine do. They fall out of it all the time, though. Look how cute they are. Real pretty scenery in the background out the window. This poor sad little cat, the roses. I love how she did this tree, or bush, or plant, whatever you want to call it. This is really, really neat. I almost did this one first. Oh, I just noticed the little mouse. I didn't see him before. He's got a little heart on him. What is this called? Braided stem. A wisteria. Oh, it's a wisteria plant. I forgot. Here we go. There's a blue jay, a little kitty, probably trying to eat him. This is the page from the cover. Really, really pretty. I don't know if you covered that. He's so cute. Just like sitting in a basket. My cat's always sitting in my boxes from Amazon. I love the owl. This is the one I finished. Well, I have some more details I want to do on it with the white pen. But I started out with watercolor. I used the Derwent Ink Tints. And then I followed it up with some details by using some polychromos. And here's my little calico cat that I tried to color. Some people, they don't like the watercolor because it makes your pages crinkle. Me, it doesn't bother me. I think the sound is cool. I'm weird. Look at the little kitten popping up behind the plant. Ugh, adorable. There's a Maine Coon. We got the deer. They're all hiding. We got the owl. Bonus selection. These are some samples from her other books. Oh, I love this. I love little whimsical fairy type houses, mushroom houses, etc. I have to go get this book. It's called Fairy Houses and Fairy Doors. And to me, this one looks like a pine cone. I love that. That's probably what I'm going to color next, I think. This one is from her Undersea Tropical Wonders. Isn't it pretty? Very, very, very good artist. This one is from her Fantastic Flora and Fauna, Volume 2, Cuddly Cats and Kittens. Here's another one. Looks like the roof is a pine cone. Another Fairy Houses and Fairy Doors, Volume 2. These are both from her Fantastic Flora and Fauna, Volume 2, Cuddly Cats and Kittens. Look at the Zen take. This would take a while, but it would be really, really pretty when it's colored in. This one, too. I like this one, too. This one is Ying and Yang Zen Doodles for a mindful coloring. We got the Buddha. This is cool. Oh, here you go. She says this page, you can use this sheet to put in between so you don't, like a blotter, you know, or you can test on it. And this is interesting. I really like how she did this. You can use this page as a tester for your coloring. You can blend, keep the color so you know what you used as you went along. And she's got a little grid here. This is very, very smart. I wish a lot of books came with something like this. It would be very, very helpful. And then she's got all of her books here. The name, the title, where you can purchase it over at Amazon. And we have another little article about her. And this is some of her other social media sites. And I'll put a link down at the bottom so you guys can just click on it. And this is about the book. It is such a nice book. I really, really enjoyed coloring in it. I'm looking forward to coloring another page. I just love cats and kittens so much. And the book is well done, very detailed. You can color in this book. I wouldn't say it was too advanced. There are some pages maybe like this that may take a while, but this is one of those that you don't want to rush anyway because it's so pretty. You want to really get in there with your fine liners and details and work it out. This is a beautiful page. So yeah, take a look at it. If you have any questions or comments, please leave it down at the bottom for me and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Please leave a like and subscribe. I would really appreciate it. Thanks so much. Bye-bye.